Hey my air signs, welcome back to Pure Black Magic, emphasis on the pure, the black, and the magic. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Dee. Thank you guys for taking the time to check out the channel. Hopefully you find clarity through this message, you like the vibe here, the energy, and you decide to hit that subscribe button. If you are returning, super, super thank you for all of your continued love and support of the channel, you guys. It is always greatly appreciated. So air signs, this is your weekly message. My apologies, it is a little bit late than I usually upload, but it's for the week of December the 12th through the 19th, okay, give or take a couple of days. Cross watchers are welcome here as well if you are involved with an air sign. Everyone, just please keep in mind that these are general messages. It might not be your messages this week and it may not entirely resonate with you, okay? So just take what does and leave what is not for the next person. Air signs, you got the power card popping out here. I'll put it back because I want to pull cards to see specifically what's going on with you this week. But you could be dealing with a Leo or a Virgo, or there could just be, I want to say there could be some sort of power struggle for you guys this week, but I'm just getting very like beastie type of energy, or just like transformation, or like a different side of you. So either this is a different side of you that's being shown, you're showing this week, or someone is viewing you differently. Something about like bringing another side of you out. I don't know exactly what's going on this week, but that's just what I'm getting from this card, okay? And then solitude is at the bottom. So some of you guys are definitely dealing with a Virgo. The song that I got for you all is Guilty by 7th Streeter featuring Chris Brown. So yeah, air signs, either you or someone else you are involved with could definitely be feeling guilty, okay? Of course, the song is about a connection. It's about two people who are like in a relationship, their own relationships, but it's like they're cheating with each other. Or there's some sort of, even if it's not necessarily physical, there's some sort of like mental or emotional like stepping out of a connection here. So whoever, I don't know which side you're on, but somebody here is feeling guilty. Maybe you are proving someone guilty this week, or somebody's proving you guilty. I am seeing this conflict and defeat card here. Look at this, okay? And right behind that, we got deception and envy, okay? And then we got material and prosperity, material and spiritual prosperity here. So it's almost like somebody put up a good front or a good show, or it's just like the last person that you would have thought that would have done this or done this to you, or vice versa here. There's some sort of deception that's hiding behind this material and spiritual prosperity. Like something that looks really good isn't really as good as it seems, okay, behind the scenes. And conflict and defeat. So yeah, take a half is resonating for you. We're gonna go ahead and hop into it with some oracle cards, and then we'll go into a regular tarot spread per usual. Please go ahead and like the video, you guys. Comment, I comment back, share, and subscribe. Look at this, came right back out. All right, so very strong energy. I don't know if this is just something that's very powerful happening this week for you guys. And then we got the throat chakra too. So, but the more you interact here with the content on the channel, the more I actually push your messages, your energy into these messages, and I can better pick up on what's going on with you. This discombobulated energy, like I feel like something is either catching you off guard, or something is catching someone you're involved with off guard, or somebody is just getting caught. Okay, that's what I'm feeling like with this energy. Y'all, look at this. Okay, so definitely Leo. Leo is all over this. Leo, Virgo, something about power. Like, it does not want to go back in. Or it's almost like something can't be unseen or unheard, or whatever's happening. Like, there's no putting the lid back on whatever is going on this week, because it's just that powerful. And then we got the Universe card at the bottom of the deck, which is Libra energy. So this could be affecting a Libra specifically. We got the Waiting Game, positive movement forward, balance. I don't know. Y'all got to let me know in the comment section how this is resonating. But this card, you saw it three times in a row, is just popping out. So let's see. I'm also seeing mental conflict here. Somebody's getting caught up. I don't know. Ooh, look at this. Mental conflict and temptation. All right, somebody's getting caught. I don't know if it's you, air signs. I don't know if it's somebody that you're dealing with. Somebody's getting caught. Somebody's getting exposed. Transformation energy here. Could be dealing with a Scorpio as well. Couple more shuffles and we'll see what comes out for you all. This damn power card comes out again. Messages for my air signs this week, spirit. All right. Ooh. And then these two fell out in a reverse. Obstacles and challenges, and then foundations and achievements in a reverse. It could for sure be affecting a home. If there was some sort of relationship that was already on edge, or somebody was already like halfway out the door or something, whatever's happening is putting the icing on the cake this week. Okay, we got triumph and we got throat chakra. It's almost like somebody has proof, or someone has some sort of receipts that someone else was not doing something they were supposed to be doing here. All right, so messages from my air signs this week, spirit. Let's see. Let's go ahead and pull, because the cards are coming out, popping out all crazy. Feel like it's going to be kind of a crazy type of week. We got the waiting game, okay? We got the power card. It came right back out with the waiting game. I don't know if you are waiting for some sort of confirmation or to catch somebody up, or someone else is waiting to catch you up. But this power energy, it's like, it's almost like finally having tangible proof. The ball is in someone's court here. Somebody has the upper hand, okay? I don't know if it's you or not, air signs. Material, spiritual prosperity, the crown chakra, and solitude, okay? A lot of Leo, a lot of Virgo energy, throat chakra, Taurus energy showing up here. I kind of feel like somebody is gonna... It's only a matter of time before something catches up to someone. So if you are this person, or someone you're dealing with is doing something they're not supposed to be doing, okay, whether it's like romantic cheating or just some sort of shadiness in a friend circle or in a workplace, someone is going to find out about it, or someone is like hearing about it. It could be hearsay. Somebody's like tricking on you, like somebody's finding out about something here. Definitely getting some sort of clarity, and I feel like that's either going to result in you or whoever you're dealing with to pull back their energy with the solitude card. Authority, patience, trapped in fear. I don't know if somebody, if you are, it's like someone's getting caught. For some of you guys, it's not the person, like it's not your person that's catching you, or it's not you that's catching your person. It's like somebody completely different, maybe a friend of a friend or something like that. Some sort of word is getting back to you guys this week about a third party situation, okay, or something that someone is guilty about. That's just what I'm seeing. That's what I gotta say. So let's see, let's move forward. Ooh, we air signs. I want to say, ooh, we Gemini. So something about a Gemini specifically, maybe for you guys. We got the Three of Swords at the bottom of, look at this, at the bottom of the deck. I pre-shuffled these cards. It's almost like getting confirmation to something that you knew to be true, maybe intuitively or whatever this is. It's just very much so like a letdown. Five of Pentacles behind that, and then we got the Queen of Cups. If you are dealing with a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, I feel like this person is going to release you, okay? Some sort of water energy here. Knight of Wands, Ten of Swords, the Devil card. It's like very toxic. It's almost like maybe this is a past person for some of you guys trying to like come back around, and you are not hearing it because of the history between you two. Like now not allowing this person to come back in, okay, and break your heart again. Or this is the message for some of you guys, okay? So let's see, spirit. What messages do we have for my air signs this week? Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. I keep seeing this Three of Swords, and I'm seeing the Ten of Pentacles. For a lot of you, this is like... it's either breaking up like a family dynamic or a home. Ten of Pentacles. Now we got the Nine of Swords. Somebody's worried about some information getting out, or somebody finding out something. It could be in work, okay? Like someone's guilty in work, or there's something that an individual is not supposed to be doing. They're feeling very guilty or very just worried about being exposed about this, or someone telling on them. And I feel like this week is the week that is going to happen. Look at this. Tower card flipped over. This week is the week that is going to happen. We also have the King of Wands here. Could be dealing with the Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Strength, Magician, Tower card. It's a Leo involved here. Like a Leo is exposing someone. I'm picking up on masculine energy, like exposing a masculine figure, okay? Even the Strength card, right, is the same exact energy as that Power card that kept coming out in the Oracle deck for you guys. Something here is like one and the same. You know what I'm getting to? It's almost like, so if there was someone here that was stepping out of a relationship, or they're guilty at something, whoever you were doing this something with, okay, or whoever this person was doing this something with, it's almost like that is the energy, that is the person, whether it's the side chick, side dude, the person who helped them commit the crime, whatever, that's the energy that's tattling, that's the energy that's tricking here. We got the high priestess. Okay, I feel like you already are hit to this, air signs. Let me see, something is backfiring here. Couple more shuffles, messages for my air signs. Messages for my air signs. I'm seeing this Knight of Cups, so an apology or something could be happening to the Cups. Could be dealing with the water sign here. And the Temperance card. Spirit, what messages do we have for the week? Anything we need to know for the air signs? Any clarity, any confirmations for my air signs? All right, this Nine of Swords was trying to stick out up here too. So let's see. I feel like air signs is you. I feel like you are the ones that are worried. Let me know which side of the coin is this resonates for you. We got the Page of Wands. Here's that message. We got the Eight of Swords. Some sort of message is coming in. Could be from a fire sign. High Priestess. Something is confirming your confirmation, okay? Or something is confirming the confirmation of someone else that you're dealing with. Like if someone is suspicious of you and they have reason to be, it's something that's being found out here. All right, let me see. Something you've been in your head about or vice versa for the person that you're dealing with. The Strength card came out again, y'all. Look at this. Y'all saw me shuffle this. Three of Swords in the heart of your energy here. Let me see what it's and Knight of Cups. But I'm getting an apology. So for some of you guys, this is past energy. Like you've already found out whatever needed to be found out. Okay, something was exposed. Someone is guilty of something. And if this is past energy, this same person is like wanting to apologize. Okay, or something about you intuitively knowing that someone was offering some sort of love gestures to someone else. It's confirmation that's coming in this week. And then for some of you guys, yeah, it's you finding out this information this week. Let me see. Tower card came right back out. I feel like someone, whoever's in the wrong here, whoever's guilty, was really working to like hide this information or keep this from being exposed. Then we got the King of Wands and we got the King of Swords. Somebody is going to be forced to think about their actions this week. It's like everything is hitting a fan or I'm hearing like explosive, like something is exploding or something is just like popping off this week with the energy. Look at what's at the bottom of the deck, the Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords with the Three of Swords energy in the middle is the Ten of Swords. That's just like the ultimate defeat here, ultimate letdown. Seven of Swords is deceptive energy. The name of y'all song is Guilty. Like behind this, we got the Five of Cups. Somebody is regretting something that they did here, okay? And I really feel like it's you, air signs. It could be a person that you're dealing with, but somebody's regretting deceptive ways because something here is coming to the light. You could just look at this Sun card on the Seven of Swords. Even this crow that's very loud. It's like somebody's telling or it's just something that's being exposed here. And behind this Five of Cups, we got the Queen of Swords. So we have the King of Swords already down here. We got the Queen of Swords, the Five of Cups, and the Seven of Swords. I'm just really getting a couple. Could be married. Don't have to be. Some sort of couple dynamic here. And it's like the shadiness, whatever is being done in the dark, is definitely coming to light. Whether this is a side person that's tricking. Somebody's exposing someone here. We got the Knight of Swords. Somebody is telling a feminine energy this. Six of Cups. Somebody could have been messing with someone else from their past. Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Wands. Yep, investing in maybe it's a Leo. It's like a fire sign here. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Five of Wands. I'm also getting to like this person, this past person. Somebody's guilty regardless. Don't get me wrong. But I feel like this side person here, if this is resonating for you, it's like they're just getting a kick out of causing chaos and conflict between the official couple. Okay, so whatever happened definitely still happened. There's no excuse here, but it's almost like the pettiness of the side person. I don't know if whoever is guilty chose to cut this person off and someone got mad or what's going on here. Look at this, Four of Wands, Three of Cups. It's a third party situation. Eight of Pentacles. Somebody was investing in like a whole other relationship. You could be figuring out that somebody here is married or committed or has a family and you were totally unaware, okay? Or somebody's finding out that about you. And as soon as it comes out, Six of Pentacles, Eight of Cups, like this person is gone. Eight of Wands with the quickness and a Chariot card. A lot of y'all are dealing with the water sign. Page of Swords, Knight of Wands, Two of Swords, Two of Wands. Ooh, it's giving messy. All right. Let's see. I want to use the actual Love Oracle cards for you guys to see what comes out with the Love Oracle deck. Ooh, we got ex-lover at the bottom of the deck. So, I feel like, okay, it's a lot of different scenarios. However, this ex-lover can, you know, resonate for you if this is your story. But I'm getting that someone will be an ex after this week, like officially ending, not going back. It's what I'm getting. And behind ex-lover, we got wedding. We got proposal, we got wedding, and we got ex-lover. Someone could have been dipping and dabbing with their ex, but I kind of feel like something is just ending very quickly here. Maybe this was a short-term relationship with proposal, wedding, and ex-lover, because it's kind of like something comes to a all of a sudden stop or all of a sudden halt this week. Okay, proposal, wedding, ex-lover. Let's see. But let's shuffle. Intuition showing up here again. Okay, I feel like this is just suspicions being confirmed here. Romantic feelings. If you had a feeling that your person had romantic feelings for someone else or was pulling back their energy, between the lines, soulmate. Someone is just caught in between two people here. Somebody that they are like legally with and someone else that was like a fling. Messages from my air signs this week, spirit. Any more messages? What's going on in their love life? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. I'm going to cut you guys and then pull from the deck to see what's going on. Messages for my air signs. Love messages. So, storm warning. Look at this. I can't make this up, y'all. Storm warning. Secret crush. Could be finding out about a secret person. Like someone else. Someone's energy was going elsewhere. Truth. Look at this. What else, spirit? Finances. I feel like this is just someone else investing elsewhere, unfinished business. It was like a fling, or someone may have not really detached from another person, like completely cut ties here. It's like you're finding out that someone was spending money on this person, giving gifts to this person, seeing this person. It's almost like it was a whole nother relationship behind the scenes of the relationship you had, had with this person. Snake. Look at this. And snake is coming out underneath the truth card here. You're finding out the truth about someone very close to you. Someone you share a home with. I don't know. Bed. Something. It's like strong ties to this connection. Intuition. And your intuition could have been telling you something about like this person's energy or their money. Something. Okay. Mystery here. Secret crush. Unfinished business. And mystery. It's all coming to the light though. It's not a mystery no more. And we got music here. So facing the music. Hearing the truth. The music is playing here. Something's being revealed. And we have spiritual awakening. For a lot of you guys, it's going to be the exact clarity. Like whatever it is that you need to move forward. To let go. Give closure in the situation. What did I say? To move forward, let go, get clarity in the situation. Behind spiritual awakening, we got ghosted and we got new lover. For some of y'all, honestly, we had new lover, hookup, and family. Honestly, I feel like some of you guys have been trying to catch someone up in something because you really don't want to be in this situation anyway. It's like you already feel detached from this relationship. And you may have your eye on someone else. Some of y'all are just looking for a reason to end a relationship. That may be valid. It might be not. It's different for everyone. But it's like either you already weren't feeling it and ready to leave. Or your person's feeling this way. Something here is just very much so on thin ice. And I feel like some of y'all are just looking for a reason to end this. And if that's the case, I feel like you're going to find what you're looking for this week. All right, so let's pull some advice for you guys. Queen of Swords at the bottom of the deck, your energy, okay? Or the energy of whoever you are dealing with. Some of y'all are dealing with another air sign. Queen of Swords, right? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and we got the Ten of Swords when I split the deck. What did I say? That first spread was giving that Ten of Swords energy. Seven of Cups. Somebody's not having it, though. Like, somebody is really not having this third-party energy. Somebody is just not really into like poly type of relationships here. Let's see, spirit. Any advice, extra messages from my air signs for this week? Anything they need to know? Any clarity, confirmation, and advice in regards to the message here for my air sign spirit. Ooh, Gemini. I mentioned Gemini specifically, right? So the Lover's card here, the Ace of Wands, the Seven of Wands. Ace with the Seven of Wands is the Eight of Wands. Something's happening very quickly, some sort of communication here. I'm hearing denial, like somebody's gonna try to deny it. Ten of Pentacles, this High Priestess is in the middle of the energy, okay? Your intuition, Pisces energy could be very significant here. I really feel like this is just something that you knew or you felt intuitively. Some of you guys are just waiting for the tangible proof. The Ace of Cups here, Two of Pentacles. It's like a choice. I don't know if you have a choice or someone else that you're dealing with has a choice, because I feel like, again, there was a lot invested here. Something was like a happy home, or something was very official, a marriage, or just a very official relationship. Two of Pentacles, the Empress card, and the Nine of Swords. This Empress is a wife here. Ace of Wands. I just feel like a feminine energy is going to be proven right, okay? And it could be masculine. It's very general reading. But the Nine of Swords, air signs, and I hate to say it, but I feel like this is your energy ending up in this Nine of Swords. It's like stress, worry. Something here is a failure. I don't know if someone was tempted and they thought things were going to work out with this third party, this mistress, this mister, and it backfires, like it was a setup, or they get played. I feel like somebody was cheating or doing something they weren't supposed to, and that ends up backfiring. Not only that, the person that they were truly, truly committed to finds out, and that ends up ending. Look at this, the Moon card at the bottom of the deck. You got the Moon with the High Priestess, Cancer energy. It's a lot of water energy here, but this is what's hitting. This is something that you already know, air signs, or this is something that someone else in your energy is very intuitive and they already know. Wheel of Fortune, Magician. It was only a matter of time for this to come out. I'm going to leave it here. Leave me a comment below in the comment section. Let me know how this is playing out for you. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel, you guys, and I will see you next time.